Meteorologist Griffin Hardy joins us live and local outside Greenville right now. Griffin, you're breaking down the different precipitation types we have here because we're frankly going to see it all coming up.
Yeah, Chris, it looks like we could see a mix of all of them. At times it could be snow, at times it could be sleet or freezing rain. And I know it may get a little bit lost in the translation, you know, what types of precipitation we could see at times, but they're a little bit different, each one of them, in terms of how they form, in terms of the impacts as well. So let's break that down for you. Snow is obviously the easiest to understand. Snow forms when temperatures are below freezing from the surface all the way up to the top of the upper atmosphere. Pretty straightforward. Sleet is a little bit different in that we normally get a layer of air just above the surface that's above freezing, and then below that, the temperatures are below freezing. So when that happens, snowflakes will melt partially before they hit the surface and then refreeze back into ice pellets before they hit the surface. So that's important to know because freezing rain is a little bit different. When that happens, the warm air is usually a little bit thicker. That layer of warm air is thicker. And when that happens, the rain freezes on contact with the surface. As soon as it hits, it's super cooled, which means whatever it sticks to immediately forms a layer of ice on top of that. And that could definitely pose the biggest threat in terms of overall impacts, because when that happens, you get ice on roadways, ice on trees, and if there's enough of it, it's enough to weigh those trees down and potentially bring them down. Same goes for power lines as well. So obviously we'll be talking all about those specific impacts. And Chris, we'll have more on the forecast for you coming up in the next 10 minutes. But for now, reporting live in Greenville, meteorologist Griffin Hardy, WYFF News 4.